गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ बृहन मुंबई म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन, एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट, एंड आई एम हियर टू प्रेजेंट माय ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 6 इंग्लिश मीडियम एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज मैथमेटिक्स एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इज HCF एंड LCM। माई सेल्फ नेहा धानके इज योर टूडेज एक्सपर्ट टीचर। सो आई होप दैट द सेशन विल बी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड यू ऑल प्लीज ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड कोप अप विद मी। ओके, सो वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग अ सेशन। सो लेट्स रिकॉल वॉट वी हैव स्टडीड इन अ अर्लियर स्टैंडर्ड। राइट, मैथ्स इज अ सब्जेक्ट विच इज ऑलवेज कनेक्टेड टू द प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड्स और द प्रीवियस कंसेप्ट्स दैट विच वी हैव लर्न। सो नाउ वी विल बी जस्ट रिकॉल इन इंट्रोडक्शन, वी विल जस्ट रिकॉल वॉट वी हैव स्टडीड इन स्टैंडर्ड 5th। सो इफ एनी वन इज लाइक दिस इज अ मैथ्स, सो वी नीड टू कंटिन्यूसली communicate with each other or we need to interact, so you can freely try to give your answers. So there are some words flashing over the screen, some words are scrolling in the screen, so any one of you can read those words for me. Yes, Pankhini. Anyone, you can randomly give the answers. You can unmute yourself and give the answer.
Miss, yes. Divisor, dividend, yes. Reminder, quotient.
Very good, Pankhini. Divisor, dividend, reminder, and quotient. Can you tell me this with which operation these words are related to? Mathematical, concept operations of these words are related? These words are used in which sum? Hum log kaun se sum mein ye word use karte hain?
Division.
Very good, Karthik Singh. We use this word in division. Very nice. So now you will be seeing one division problem on your screen. Why 28 is divided by 24? Okay. So in this division sums, we have different numbers. Okay. We have 22 over here. We have 528. Then we have 0, and we have 24. Okay, my mic is mute. Okay, can you all hear me?
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you, sir. So we have different numbers over here: 22, 528, 0, and 24. So every number has its own name and it has its own place. Okay. So we will see what these numbers are called. This also you have studied in earlier standards, that these numbers have their
Excuse me, teacher. Your two mics are on. Use any one mic. Either PC is connected mic or a mobile connected mic.
Okay, now it's okay?
Yeah, right.
Okay, sorry. So we have the so these numbers have their own name. So we will now, I will like to ask you, I will like to just tell me what these numbers are called. So any one of you, what 22 is known as? What 22 is known as? 20.
Teacher, question 10.
Very good. Question, right. You're right. 22 is known as quotient, and that is the answer of the division sum that we get. So 22 is our quotient. Okay. Next, what 528 is called?
Dividend.
Very nice. 528 is a dividend. A zero.
Remainder.
Very good, Neeraj. 0 is our remainder. And what is 24?
Divisor.
Very good. So these are the words that we mostly use in the sum of division, quotient, dividend, remainder, and divisor. Okay. So can we all say that by looking at the sum, 528 is completely divided by 24? Can we say this? That 528 is completely divided by 24? Yes, we can say that 524 is completed because the remainder is zero. We get here the remainder zero.
Yes.
When we get the remainder zero, we can say the number is completely divided. Okay. Now we will see one more division sum over here. Simple sum I will take for you people. If I take 20 divided by 5, okay, 20 divided by 5. What will I get in the question? Question mein kya milega mujhe upar? 5. Very good. 5 fours are 20. Very nice, Vaibhav. 5 fours are 20 and I'm going to get the remainder as 0 again. Okay. So I can say 20 is completely divided by 5. But in the similar case, if I take 16 divided by 5. Okay. 16 divided by 5. I'm going to take 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10. 5 threes are 15. Okay. So 16 minus 15 is answer 1. So I'm not getting the remainder as 0. I'm getting the remainder as 1. So here I can say 16 is not completely divided by 5. Okay. So see, in this case, we can say it is completely divided, but in this case, we can say it is not completely divided. So, today we are going to see this concept. Today we are going to see this concept only. When the number is completely divided, what it is called, and when the number is not completely divided, what it is called. So, when the number is completely divided, it is known as factor. Now I can say 5 is a factor of 20, but 5 is not a factor of 16 because here it is completely divided, so it is a factor. But when it is not completely divided, it is not a factor. So this only we are going to see in this session, that what is a factor. So the basic hamara jo topic hai, that is highest common factor. But we will divide the topic in 3 parts. First we will see what is factor, then we will see what is common factor, and then we will see what is the highest common factor. So now we will see what is a factor. Okay, so if I will go with the definition, what factor is, I can say factor of a number divides that number exactly. Means if number is divided by a particular number and if we are getting it zero, then that number is a factor of that particular number. And if it is not dividing, then that number is not a factor of that number. Okay. So we will, by definition also we can understand, but it is more easier for us to understand with the help of when we go through the sums, right? Because max is mostly we keep on solving and understanding. The maximum you solve, the maximum you understand. So we will see the sum. So first sum that we are going to see, find the factor of 24. Now here we are going to find what are the factors of 24. So can any one of you tell me 24 is divided by which all numbers? We will go in ascending order, okay? We will start from 1 and then we will go ahead. By which all numbers 24 is divided by?
Miss.
Yes.
1.
Yes.
Two.
Okay. We will go slowly. First we will see 1. Okay. So we can say 24 is 24. Okay. Next.
2.
Okay. 2 how many? 2 twelves are. Okay. 2 twelves are is 24. Very good. Next.
3.
3 eights are is 24. Very good. Next.
4.
Very good. 4 6 is 24. Any other number which is through on which 24 goes?
Yes.
Yes, beta. Which number mein jata hai?
6.
Okay, 6. Very good. We have already taken 6, right? 6 4s are 24. 4 6 are 24. Okay, hum log ne 6 le liya. Any other, like 8 3s are. वी कैन सी हियर. इसके अलावा और कोई नंबर में जाता है?
यस मिस, 12.
12 सी हियर, 12 इज देयर. 12 टूज आर 24, वी हैव टेकन. 2 12s एंड 12 2s आर वन एट द सेम. ओके, गुड. सो दिस आर द नंबर्स इन व्हिच 24 गोस. सो वी कैन से वी हैव नंबर हियर 1 2 3 4 6 8 12 एंड 24. ये सब नंबर में 24 इज डिवाइडेड. ओके, सो वी कैन से 24, सो द फैक्टर्स ऑफ 24 आर 1 2 3 4 6 8 12 एंड 24. If I will take the number 7 over here and if I will see that 7 is 7 a factor of 24? 7 24 ka factor hai kya?
No miss.
No. Why? Because 24 is not divided by 7. If we will try to divide 24 by 7, we are going to get remainder as 3. So humko 3 remainder milega. So hum log bolenge 24, 7 is not a factor of 24. So next, one more example we will see with the similar factor ka example dekhenge. See, now we are going to find the factor of 36. So 36 goes in which all table? Abhi those who jisne answer diya hai na, those students don't try to give, others jisne nahi diya you can also give. Okay, chalo batao, who all can give? 36 goes in which all tables? Ya phir 36
is I am telling.
Yes Pooja, bolo.
Yes miss. 3.
Okay, can we go with 1? Means we will go in ascending order.
Okay miss.
Okay,
and then 3.
2, it doesn't go in 2's table. Okay, it goes in 3's table. 3 12s are 36, 2 18s are also 36, and
4.
Four how many is a 36?
Four eights are 30. Sorry, four nines are 36.
Very good, very good. Four nines are 36. Any other table it goes?
Six.
Very good. Six sixes are 36. So yes, we have this all numbers. Beyond this numbers,
36 are last.
Yes, yes. 36 ones are, we have already mentioned over here, right? 1, 36 are 36, and 36 ones are 36. So, these are the numbers in which 36 goes. So, we can say factors of 36 are, what are the factors of 36? Batao, koi bata sakta hai? Anyone?
Yes, miss. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 36, 18, 12, 9, or 6.
Very good. Very good, Pooja. But have you noticed that you have said 6 two times, right? We have to take only 1 6. Hum log ek 6 ko, whether it is two times also, we will take only once. Okay. So the factors of 36 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12, 18 and 36. Very good. So we have learned what are the factors. Factors means the number which is completely, the number which completely divides the dividend. Dividend is completely divided by divisor. So divisor is a factor of dividend. So next we are going to see, here is a note for you, same what I have said earlier. When 24 is divided by 4, remainder is 0. That means 4 is a factor of 24. When 24 is divided by 5, the remainder is not 0. Therefore 5 is not a factor of 24. So understanding the factor and finding the factor is more important. Aage ka steps to very easy. They all are very easy. But what, how to find the factors, for that you should be thorough with tables also, and you should be thorough with division also. If you know the division better, it will be very easy for you all to find the factors. So if you are trying to practice the sums, first, try to practice the division. If you know the division better, you will be able to find the factors very easily. Okay. So, next we are going to see. So, we have seen factors. Okay. In this slide, we have learned what are the factors. Now, we will see what is called common factors. So, we can see there is one girl and one boy on my screen. On the right hand side, there is a boy. On the left hand side, there is a girl. Okay, anyone, what is common in both of them? What is common? Yes, Mahi.
One boy is standing and one girl is sitting.
Very good, Mahi. Your answer is nice, but I want common. Common kya hai? Same kya hai dono mein?
ये भी idea लगा रहा है.
हाँ, right?
Miss, इसको भी idea में इस ये भी कुछ सोच रहा है और ये भी कुछ सोच रही है.
Very good, Mahina. Great answer. Both have common thing, that is they are thinking something. Right? Boy is also thinking something. Girl is also thinking something. Boy also have two eyes. Even girl have two eyes. Boy have 2 ears. Girl have 2 ears. That means we can say something is common, but something is different. Dono mein common bhi bahut hai. And dono, both have difference or both have two similar things also. And they have differences also. So in this, on this slide, we are going to see what is common and what is different. That means we are going to see what is common factors. Okay, jaise abhi hum log ne girl aur boy mein dekha, are both of them are thinking, right? Both have kuch common in them. Similar way, we are going to see what are common factors. We will be dealing with two numbers and what is the common in both the numbers that we are going to see. So common factors. So every word, if we can say in mathematics, every concept in mathematics, we have one definition. So we will go by definition also. If two or more numbers have the same number as their factors, those factors are called common factors. If two or more numbers have same number, if both the numbers are having similar number, one number as their factor, then that number we are going to call as common factors. So definition say also we will understand, but max is a subject which we understand more by examples. So we will see one example over here. Now we are going to find the factor of 12 and 16. We are solving plus we are understanding. Okay, so you should also understand. Just keep on seeing on the screen and try to mug up. You just understand what we are going. We are just going with the flow. First we find the factors. Now we are going to see what is common factor. So we will be seeing common factors between 12 and 16. So what are the factors of 12? 12 ka factors I want to know. Am I right? Factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Because 12 goes in all these tables and 12 is, all these numbers completely divide 12. So that is 2 threes are, we can say 2 threes are, sorry, 2 sixes are 12, 3 fours are 12, 4 threes are 12, 6 twos are 12, 12 ones are 12 and 1 twelves are 12. So all these numbers are the factors of 12. Okay. Now factors of 16 also. We will see factors of 16 are 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. These are the factors of 16. Now we have two numbers. We have 12 also and we have 16 also, like one girl and one boy. But now we have to find out what is common in both of these numbers. Okay. We will see what is common in both the numbers. What is common in both the numbers? Which numbers are common? If they are in 12 also and they are in 16 also.
1, 2, 4. Bas itna hai.
1, 2, 4. Okay. We have three numbers in common. 1, 2 and 4. 3 is not common. 6 is not common. 12 is also not common. 8 is also not common and 16 also. Dono mein kaun sa number hai? So it is 1, 2 and 4. So we have common factors. 1, 2 and 4. This is called common factors. Abhi hum logne sirf common factors dekha hai. One more example we will see. Now we will find the factors of 21 and 24. Factors of 21 are 1, 3, 7 and 21. Factors of 24 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24. So we see, first we have learned how to find the factors. Now we are going to, so now I will say that you know how to find the factors. Now we will see what is common, okay, in these two numbers also. So we have 21 and 24. Yes, Pooja, you can.
1 and 1 3. And,
okay, any other number we have common?
No, miss.
No, okay, very good. So we have 1 in both and we have 3 also. No other number is common. 7 is not there, not a factor of 24. Even 21 is not a factor of 24. So this, we have only 1 and 3. In common.
Okay. Common factor.
So now we have studied what is common factor. When we have to compare, when we have to see two or more numbers, we have to find out common factor. So now we are going to see what is highest common factor. We have seen factors first, okay? Then we have seen common factor after that. Now we are going to see what is highest common factor, and that is called HCF. That is HCF. Hum log ka jo lesson ka naam hai, you know, HCF and LCM. So today we are going to see only HCF. So HCF means highest common factor. Highest common factor, HCF. Find HCF of 15 and 25. We have to find the HCF of 15 and 25. For that, first what we need to do, anyone can tell me, kya karna chahiye hame pehle? First what we will do?
First box we'll do, and then write a box 15, comma, okay. 25.
Okay, very good, very good, nice. First we will find what we will find first, but we will draw the box. Okay, that is good answer. And what else we can do?
Miss, first write 15 and which table, matlab jis table mein 15 jata hai, ek side mein udhar likhne ka aur fir wahan pe jata hai wo likhne ka.
Very good, very good, Mahi, great answer. First we are going to find the factors of 15. Then we will find the factors of 25, and then we will see what we are going to do next. Okay. First, we have find your factors of 15 and factors of 25. So, first step that we are going to do is find all the factors. Hum log first step kya karne wale hai? Find all the factors of the given number. So, we have already done 15. Factors of 15 are 1, 3, 5, and 15. Factors of 25 are 1, 5, and 25. So first step we have completed, finding the factors. Next step that we are going to see is identify the common factors. Okay, we have studied in the previous slide that we have to find common factors in both of them. So what is the common factors in both of these numbers? What is common factors? We have two numbers and we have their factors also. So what is the common factor in 15 and 25?
Means?
Yes, Pankhini.
1, 5.
One and five.
1
is there and 5 is there. Okay. So is 3 a common factor? 3 common factor hai kya?
No, miss.
Very good. 3 is not a, 15 is also not common, and even 25 is not common. So we have only 1 and 5. Common. So now we have find out what is common factor. Next step we are going to do is largest common factor. So now we have two common factors, 1 and 5. Okay. So this is my first common and this is my second common. What is the largest common factor, biggest common factor, both of them, from both of them, which is the biggest? Yes, Shivam, you can answer.
Please.
Okay.
Can I?
Yes, Pankhini.
5.
5, very good. So, from both the answers, 5 is the highest common factor. So, we can say common factors are 1 and 5. And the highest, dono mein se highest kaun sa hai? So, only 5. Highest means the biggest number, the greatest number that we have. So, highest common factor is only 1. Common factor, we can get multiple common factors, we can get. we can get four common factors, we can get five common factors, multiple common factors we can get. But the highest one, जो सबसे बड़ा होगा, the highest, the greatest number will be the HCF of our sum. So highest common factor means सबसे बड़ा number. जो भी common fact, common numbers में, the greatest one, that number is called highest common factor. So we have 1 and 5, and the highest one is 5. So the HCF of 5 and 25 is 5. So our answer is 5. Okay. So this one sum we have seen. We will be seeing one more sum. So see, yes, we have done. Enough. Even we have solved the sum. Now we will see one more sum. Similar problem we will see. Find the HCF of 6, 12, and 18. Now, in previous slide, we have find the HCF of two numbers. Now we are going to find the HCF of three numbers.
Okay. Yes, since I am
six. Wait, Pooja. 6, 12, and 18. So, first, what we are going to do, we are going to find the factors individually. First, we will find the factors of 6. Then we will find the factors of 12. Then we will find the factors of 18. Okay. So, in this table, we can see we have factors of all the three numbers. Factors of 6, factor of 12, and factor of 18. So, what are the factors of 6? What are the factors of 6? Yes, ma'am. Avinash, bolo.
Yes.
What six. Are the yes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12.
Oh my God, I want factors of 6 only.
Only 6?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 6.
Oh, very good, Avinash. We have 1, 2, 3, and 6. Now tell me the factors of 12. Anyone, just unmute yourself and give the answer.
Teacher, 1, 2.
Yes, 1, 2.
3.
Yes. 3, 4, 6, 12.
4, 3, 6, yes. 12.
Very good. So we have six factors of 12. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. Next, I want the factors of 18 now.
Teacher, 2.
Yes.
3.
Yes.
6.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 18.
18. Okay, very good. So we have these things. These are the factors of 6, 12, and 18. Hamara jo first step hai to find the HCF, we need to find the factors first. After that, our second step is we have to. What we are supposed to do, we have to just find the common factors. We have factors. Now we will see what is common factor in all the three. What is common that we can see? Student, those who have not given answer, try to give the answers. Yes, Vedant? Anyone? What is common in all the three numbers?
Miss,
yes,
there are one
is there. Okay, two. One is there in all the three numbers. We have two also in all the three numbers. Very good. And
six.
Okay, six is there in all the three numbers. And which number is there? We have written one, we have written two, and we have written six. Any other number which is common?
Three.
Okay, very good. We have three also common in all the three numbers. So see, here we have three numbers. So sometimes it may happen that common is there between only two numbers. Suppose if I say here might be 7, and here also there is a 7 factor. So, 7 in there in two numbers. 7 is a factor of two numbers. But 7 is not a factor of the first number. Okay, so we cannot take 7 because it is factor of only two numbers. When it belongs to only two numbers, we are not supposed. So that is not the common. We have to see in all the three numbers. Common tino number mein hona chahiye, not only in two numbers. So we are going to say that 2, 1, 2, 3, and 6 are the factors of, are the common factors, sorry, are the common factors of 6, 12, and 18. From these numbers, which is the highest, which is the greatest number? 1, 2, 3, and 6. Isme sabse bada number kaun sa hai?
6.
Okay. So we have 6 is the biggest number, greatest number from all the four. So we can say the HCF is 6. Okay. We have, I have already written over here. So the HCF of our sum is 6. So HCF of 6, 12 and 18 is 6 that we have found out. Now, we are going to see one example of the bigger, like greater number we will take. We will try to understand. Hum log ne abhi chota chota numbers liya tha. So it was easy for us to find the factors. It was easier for us to deal with the numbers. But when it comes to the bigger numbers like 122, 144, if you will see in your practice set also, there are many numbers. We have we have many numbers in common. We have 3-digit number also there. We have in one sum, we have 4-digit number also. So all this, we should be able to deal with those numbers also. So one bigger, one greater number, biggest number we have, I have taken. So that is 120 and 120 and 124. So I can say this is, these are the bigger numbers. So for that, first I need to find the factors of 120. So I have done here for you all to make it easy. 120 goes in which all tables? Konse table mein 120 jata hai? So can anyone read for me? 120 goes in which all tables? You have to just read it. Anyone? Okay, Karthik. Yes.
1.
Yes.
4.
Yes.
5.
Yes.
6.
Yes.
340 ja
3. Yes, very good. 340 ja 120.
15 8 ja
15 8 ja 120. Very good.
Yes, Anisha.
260
ja 62 ja we can say. Okay, so we have factors of 120. See how many, so many factors we have got. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15, 20, 24, 30, 40, 60, 120. We have so many factors. Why we got so many factors? Because it is a bigger number. When you go for the bigger numbers, you will get more and more factors. So we have to look for more and more factors. We are, because we have to find out the highest common factor. हमको सबसे बड़ा नंबर चाहिए, so we cannot stop till 1 to 2 to 10 table. We have to go on beyond that also. We have to see 15 also. We have to see 20 also. The number, if as the number is bigger, we have to try to divide it with bigger numbers also. Now we have the number 144. अभी 120 का factors आ गया. Now we will see the factors for 144. Okay. So you can see just at the bottom of the screen, we have factors of 144. What are the factors of 144? Yes, Suraj. Avinash, can you? Anyone? Randomly.
1, 2, 3.
Yes.
4.
Yes.
6.
6. Yes.
9.
Yes. So we have, we can see on the screen, we have all the factors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 9, 48, 36, 24, 18 and 72. So we have so many factors of 144 also. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 9, 12, 16, 18, 24, 36, 72 and 48. So we have, now we have find out what is, what are the factors. 120 factor also we have find out, and we have the factors of 144 also. Now we will see what is the next step. Pata hai ka koi kya karna hai iske baad? Factors to aa gaya. What we have to do next? क्या करेंगे कोई बताएगा?
कॉमन फैक्टर ढूंढेंगे.
वेरी गुड पूजा, नाइस. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द कॉमन फैक्टर्स. सो व्हाट आर द कॉमन फैक्टर्स इन बोथ ऑफ देम? कॉमन कुछ है क्या? नहीं है, देखो एक बार.
मिस,
यस माही.
वन,
यस.
टू,
वन इज देयर, टू इज देयर. ओके, ओके.
फोर,
यस.
सिक्स,
ओके. वी हैव सिक्स आल्सो कॉमन.
एट,
यस. एट,
ट्वेल्व,
ट्वेल्व इज देयर. एनी अदर नंबर इज देयर?
ट्वेंटी फोर,
ट्वेंटी फोर इज देयर. वेरी गुड. ओके गुड. सो वी हैव दिस मच ओनली कॉमन फैक्टर्स. वी हैव वन. सो द कॉमन फैक्टर्स दैट वी हैव आर 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24. सो दिस आर द कॉमन फैक्टर्स दैट वी हैव नाउ. बट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द हाइएस्ट कॉमन फैक्टर. विच इज द हाइएस्ट वन, विच इज द ग्रेटेस्ट वन विद फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ देम? What we will do? Yes,
24.
Right. Yes, so 24 is the greatest number, bigger number, greater number from all of them. So, सबसे बड़ा number है इसमें common में 24. So, I can say the HCF of 120 and 124 is 24. See, this was so easy, na? HCF, to find the HCF, it is very easy. But the difficult part of this is to find the factors. We should know the factors, then we can easily find out the HCF also. So we have this sums. Now, see, I will like to say, tell you that this, ye sums to ho gaya. This were the numerical sums that we have done. But there are also, sometimes it comes, we have to deal with word problems also. When you will go in higher standards, or when you will try to go for competitive exams, that times you have to, HCF and LCM is the basic topic that we have for our competitive exams. Okay. So in that competitive exams, we need to solve the some word problems also. So it is not that we have to just see, go for the numerical ones. We have to see the word problems also. So even in our practice set, even in our textbook, we have 8 to 10 word problems. Out of it, one of them we are going to solve over here, and we will try to understand what we are doing, whether we know or whether we have understood the concept of HCF. We will try to understand from this sum. Okay, so There is a word problem that I'm going to read for you all. There are 48 kg of jawar and 54 kg of wheat in a shop. All the grains are to be picked in a bag. Are to have an equal weight of grains. What is the maximum weight of grains that can be filled in each bag? So we have to find out the maximum weight of grains that can be filled in each bag. Now see, we have total 48 kg and 54 kg of grains. So what we have to make different bags. हमको अलग अलग bags बनाना है. और they have asked कि एक bag में कितना weight आएगा. Okay. So by looking at this, you should understand what operation we have to. Just by looking at the sum, we will try to understand what operation we are going to do over here. see, they have asked that what grains can be filled in each bag. When the word comes to each bag, each student, one student, anything like this, when we have to find it for one thing, we always try to divide the number by the other number. Hum log hamesha divide karte when we have to find the quantity of one. Okay, so here we have to find the quantity of one, but we have two items over here. We have 48 kg of jawar and we have 54 kg of wheat. We have two quantities. So what we will do, even we have to divide also, and we have to find out here one more word is there, that is maximum weight. Sabse zyada weight. We are not only supposed to divide, but we have the answer they want. They want the maximum weight that can be filled in each bag. So for this, when the word comes maximum and the when the word comes each, we have to always remember that we have to find the HCF. Hum log ko HCF find out karna hai, okay? So I will say that this word problem is related to HCF. This we have understood. Ye clear ho gaya. Now we will see how to find the numbers. Are very easy. With the same format, we are going to find out the HCF, and then we will be dealing with. As it is a word problem, we are not only just supposed to find the HCF and leave it. We have to also write the statement. So first, we will find the HCF. Okay, so we have your jawar of 48 kg, and we have wheat also of 54 kg. So we have 48 kg jawar, 58 kg wheat, and the weight of the grains in each bag must be a factor of 48 and 54. And when if it is completely divided, means sabko barabar divide kiya, that means it is completely divided. So by natural, we have to find out the factors of 48 and the factors of 54. Beside the maximum possible weight must be filled in each bag. Hence, let us find the HCF. The same explanation I gave you just before, that first we have to find the factors. That means we have to divide. And then they have asked for maximum possible weight. So maximum means highest possible weight, that is HCF. So factors of 48 are, so first we will find the factors of 48. So I have done here for you. Factors of 48 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12, 16, 24, and 48. So we have factors of 48. Now we will find the factors of 54. We have two numbers, right? We have 48 and 54. So now we will find the factors of 54. So here I have done factors of 54 also. Factors of 54 are 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 18, and 27. So this now first step we have done factors. Of 48 ka bhi factors we have done, 54 factors also we have find out. Now what is the next step? Next step we have to, what we can do? Next step, anyone can tell? Kya karna hai next step? Always after finding the factors.
Miss!
Yes.
We have to find the common factor.
Very good. We have to find the common factors.
Common.
So, what are the common factors in this?
One. Two.
Yes.
Three.
Yes.
Six.
Yes.
Bas miss itna hi hai.
Okay, itna hi hai. So, we have only four common factors. So, the common factors that we have is 1, 2, 3 and 6. So from this common factors, now we have to find the maximum weight. We have 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg and 6 kg. Which is the maximum weight out of this? Balram?
Yes, teacher.
Maximum weight. Which is the maximum weight out of this all four weights?
6.
Very good. So we have 6 as the maximum weight. So what we can say, what is 6 for us? 6, the answer jo humko mila hai, wo kya hai hamara?
Maximum weight, HCF.
HCF. So we have HCF over here, and the 6 is our common factors C. Of the common factors 48 and 54, 6 is the greatest. That is, 6 is the HCF of the number 48 and 54. Therefore, the maximum of 6 kg of grains can be filled in each bag. So we have also written statements over here. As it is a word problem, so sometimes it is mandatory to write the statements when we are solving the examples for the school papers. So as statements, sometimes it happens that statements also have marks, but our full and final aim is to find the last final answer. But sometimes you also need to write the statements. So be particular with your statements also. So I have written statement over here. Therefore, the maximum 6 kg of grains can be filled in each bag. Okay. So yeah, we have done it. And now I will like to say that we have seen HCF, many problems of HCF. We have seen what is factor. We have seen what is common factor. Even we have seen what is, we have also seen word problems also. So I would like to say what I have learned today, what I know now, like even teacher know, even girls know, boys know, everyone knows what we have learned in today's lecture. Now I know that the highest common factor is the largest common factor that two or more numbers have. That this is the conclusion of our today's session. What is the highest common factor? So the highest common factor is the largest common factor, biggest common factor, or the greater common factor that two or more numbers have. So that is the HCF. To find the HCF of the given number, we make a list of factors of that number and find the greatest and of the common. Jo hum log ne kiya ki if we have to find out the HCF, first we need to find the factor, then we will find the common factor, and then we will find the HCF. Okay, so this was our today's session, a very interactive session. All like very good students, maximum students have tried to answer my questions, and maximum students have also paid attention. You all were answering, that means you were paying the attention. So that is a good thing that you have done. So I would like to tell you that we are going to end our session, and I will ask everyone to just subscribe our YouTube channel, like and share. Okay.